So Bannon was clearly speaking to a friendly crowd. I mean, he was applauded several times during his speech and people laughed at some of his jokes. The title of his speech was Trump's America First and its impact on Central Europe. But he actually spoke very little about Central Europe, and some of the people in the crowd were quite disappointed about that. He mostly spoke about U.S. issues and his vision of the world. And from the very beginning, he was very aggressive in his speech, and especially towards his two favorite enemies, the media and the global elites. The media, he called them, I quote, a pack of hyenas, the propaganda machine, and the opposition party. As for the global elites, he said that they were the worst people in the world, and he detests them, and they were not ready to hear the truth. He also talked about several issues, I mean, from the financial crisis to the U.S. elections to this new axis that he sees formed by China, Turkey, and Iran, which he still calls Persia, this new axis that is against the Judeo-Christian world and that Europeans should defend this Judeo-Christian world. So it was a lot of vague concepts with little coherence between them. And I spoke to a couple of people that attended his speech and who confirmed that they were quite disappointed, that they were hoping to hear more about Bannon's vision for Europe, especially for Central Europe and the connections with the U.S.
And Brian, you will be speaking to Bannon yourself later today, and he's already made some controversial remarks to other news channels. What will you be asking him then?
Yes, indeed, Tessa. I'm standing right in front of the hotel where Steve Bannon is staying here in Budapest, and we'll have an interview with him shortly after this this interview. He's already been speaking to several media outlets since he has been in Europe, media outlets that he usually despises, including a couple of days ago, he gave an interview to the BBC during which he had these controversial remarks regarding Martin Luther King.
Said Donald Trump has the lowest black unemployment in history. Donald Trump has the lowest Hispanic unemployment in 25 years. If you look at the policies of Donald Trump, okay, anybody, Martin Luther King would be proud of him, of what he's done for the black and Hispanic community.
So as you can see, controversial remarks indeed about Dr. King, especially given some of the remarks that Steve Bannon gave in the past. We remember when he was at the National Front in France, he said that when people call you racist, you should wear it as a badge of honor. So our questions here at Euronews will be asking Steve Bannon more specific questions about Europe and what he sees for the future of Europe. Tessa?